In this video, you will learn how to save data to a CSV formatted file and how to write files directly to a remote file system. Note that we'll be using CSV files, but data export works pretty much the same for the many other file types, such as Excel files, JSON files, and so on. Let's have a look. CSV means comma-separated values, and is the format that typically stores tabular data in plain text. The data entries are organized by rows, and the values are separated by the specified delimiter. Usually, the delimiter is a comma, but it can also be a semicolon, tab, or some other special character. Typically, the first row of the CSV file stores the column headers. Let's see how to export a data table to a CSV file in Analytics platform. You have performed some operations on your data and want to write the results on a CSV file. Add the CSV writer node to the workflow. In its configuration window, you have to define the output location of the file that you want to write in the local file system. You can provide the full absolute path, for example, via browsing the desired location. Just as in reader nodes, you can also write relatively to a specified mount point, current workflow or current workflow data area, or use a custom URL in the path. You can provide not only the existing location and the file name, but also the new folder to be created. Missing folders will be created automatically if we check the relative box. If the file already exists, you can either overwrite it, append new rows to the end of the existing file, or stop the writing operation. If you want to append new data to the existing file, note that you can check the option "Don't write column headers if file exists." This will append the new data to the table without the column headers in between. Below, you can specify the format of the CSV file. Set the column delimiter, the row delimiter, the quote, and the escape character. In the advanced settings, you can specify when to use quotes. Here, you can also set characters to use as decimal separator, as well as some additional options for numeric values. The node also gives you the possibility to set a comment in the beginning of the file and the character set for encoding. Once the node is executed, the CSV file will appear in the chosen location. You can also write the files directly to a remote file system. If you want to write the results to a file located on Amazon S3, for example, use the Amazon Authenticator and the Amazon S3 Connector node to set up the connection and specify the remote working directory. Then, provide the file system connection to the CSV writer node. The port will show up automatically, but you can also add it manually by clicking the plus icon on the bottom right corner of the node. In the CSV writer node, the output location is now set to Amazon S3. You can now provide the file path by browsing on S3 like you did for the local file system. Execute the CSV writer node to write the data to the CSV file in the specified location on Amazon S3. You can do the same for the many other cloud, remote, and distributed file systems supported, such as Google Cloud Storage, Microsoft SharePoint, Azure Blob Storage, Databricks, and more. In this video, you've learned how to save data to a CSV formatted file and how to write files directly to a remote file system.